allegedly the first chemist in the world was a female perfumer in Mesopotamia back in the day. Apparently she was making just different aromatic molecules or just different smells from like flowers or mortar and pestle, and it's techniques that have transferred through chemistry. And so when we think of STEM and science, a lot of times we think of that guy in a white lab coat, but it's fun to flip the script a little bit and think that science and maybe chemistry actually started with like a woman creating something that smells good. I'm Kathy. I'm a second year PhD student in Joanna Eisenberg's lab. We research stimuli responsive materials. On the side outside of the lab, I have been really into the science and the outreach of science through perfumes and fragrance formulations. There is a whole world of the beauty and the fashion industries that is really based on a lot of outstanding science, but they're not necessarily always marketed like that. The combination of the two has been a really fun way to merge what I know about science to connect with people about something that everyone really uses, maybe unconsciously every day. Every household product that's like soap, a detergent, laundry, everything actually has a smell component to it. It's really something that you can play with at home if you want to start natural. And then there's also so many kits now that you can buy. And if you wanted to, you could just go together and mix together all your perfumes at home. So it's really a pretty low entry thing to start trying. It's still pretty simple compared to a lot of what goes on in professional chem labs. But I set up a distillation and using orange peels, put them in a vial by heating water and running steam up through it. The steam will basically extract a bunch of the molecules that are fragrant that you want to extract from the orange peel. And then you condense it and it'll all turn the steam into something you collect, right? Liquid. And you can collect it on the other side. The chemistries that decide what smells like what are really beautifully complex. It's not like one molecule smells exactly like one thing. If you look at the top molecules that smell like rose, you'll get a ton. And some look like each other, chemical structure-wise, and some don't at all. A lot of them are little hexagons of carbons at their core. In chemistry, that's called an aromatic molecule, and that actually came from the fact that most of these like hexagon carbon molecules smelled good. So that was a fun, also intertwining of fragrance and chemistry. In my experience, at least, there's not as much value for beauty, for femininity in scientific spaces. And so when you bring it in and we normalize it a little bit, it can be really fun. And it really starts a conversation and can help people outside of STEM spaces also just have something fun and artsy and crafty to bond over. And then finally, the boundaries of like, we don't have to meet a lab to make all these crazy cool things. You can experiment at home safely, and you can inject your own opinions into science and inject art and creativity into science. Like, they're all really amorphous fields that are really beautiful together. We don't have to have these walls up between them.